Okay, the painting we are looking at is called Buca Paldo. The restaurant that we have been going to for 20 years, it is probably one of our most favorite restaurants in the planet, on the planet. And we have a very long history here. This was the very first restaurant that we went to when we took our apartment on Lugano Arcibusieri when I started my first semester at the Lorenzo de' Medici Art Institute. We actually entered through an alley, and this was the view that we came across. And our apartment was probably two blocks over behind us. And in fact, we came into this place by accident because our new landlord had recommended a restaurant which was somewhere between here and where we live. But this is where we ended up. And not knowing a soul, it has become our go-to place in Florence. And we have a 20-year history with the people, the family that owns this restaurant, and we've had some of our most favorite lunches and dinners in our lives at this very place. The painting is 24 by 32. It's an oil painting, and this was a scene right after it rained. And again, I really like to play with the image of water, and you can see that all along the left and the reflections of the light. And because it was raining, there was nobody in the place at this particular time when I was doing some sketches and photos. But the seating area outside is on the left. It's changed a little bit since then. This, again, was 1999. There are guardrails along the side, but it's pretty much the same. And over to the right is the doorway down to the restaurant. The restaurant is called Buca Paldo. Buca means hole in Italian, and basically that means the restaurant is downstairs. We prefer to go to the restaurant when in the warmer weather when we can eat outside, but we've also had wonderful times downstairs. Through the years, we met a various assortment of characters there. When the first night that we came here, which again was by accident, we sat down, and this nice waiter came over. He spoke fluent English. We assumed he was Italian. He looked Italian to us. He was very knowledgeable about the wines, the foods. He recommended the Lombatina di Vitello, which is the famous Tuscan veal steak, which really you can only get in Tuscany. And it's a veal, sort of a sirloin veal, but they cook it in garlic and oil. It's very simply in Tuscany, particularly in Florence, they don't use a lot of sauces. It's pretty much garlic and oil, no red sauce. So this was our first time, and he recommended a nice Italian red. Again, he spoke fluent English, so Susan was asking him some questions about where to get some bedding and stuff, because our apartment that we had was huge, but we had some kind of older furniture in there. So he was giving us all kinds of information. He was like our first Bible for Florence, telling us where to go to get certain pieces of furniture. And he was just a wonderful man. He introduced us to the owner. The owner at the time was named Francesco. And the co-waiter that night was a young man named Luciano, who has since, Luciano is now the current owner. But between 1999 and 2019, we've had some incredible times here. We've had several of our adult children there for dinner. We've had a group of friends from almost everybody that comes to visit us. And back in, not so much in 99, but in the mid-2000s when we were living pretty much full time, we took everybody to this place. And we've had some wonderful, wonderful evenings. On one lunchtime, our friend Brian Johnson of ACDC had his 60th birthday there, and they had the place all afternoon. Another close friend of ours, Steve Hutchinson, had his 65th birthday here. And we can go on and on with all the friends, but more importantly, the family that now owns it, it's Luciano and his brother Donatello, and we've sort of grown up with them. At the time, Donatello wasn't even working there. And over the years, Luciano and Donatello both gotten married. They've had children. And there's even an Italian story to this. Donatello is the younger of the boys, the brothers, but he was the first to have a child, and he named him Francesco after their father. Luciano had two girls, and then he had a boy, but the boy was now younger than Donatello's Francesco, and Luciano said he had to name him Francesco also because his father's dying wish to Luciano was that he name his firstborn son Francesco. So now Luciano and Donatello both have boys named Francesco. They're a wonderful group of people. We probably eat there at least once a week, sometimes twice a week, good and bad weather. They also have several paintings of mine downstairs, which one of the, they're actually prints of paintings that I did. One from the Ponte Vecchio, another of the Duomo, and then a third, which is actually a smaller version of this painting, and it's actually original. And in that painting, I have my wife, Susan, and myself. Again, one of our favorite spots on the planet, this painting is in our private collection. And again, it's a 24 by 32 inch oil painting. I would like to add, in November of 2006, this is where we took Sister Wendy Beckett and her associates, Father Rod and Father Steve, who were traveling with her. That was the day she came. They came by train from Bologna, and they were on their way to Rome. They stayed with us for the evening. She came to my studio in the afternoon, and we celebrated a very nice day at the studio at the restaurant. Unfortunately, it was a little cool, so we did go downstairs. It was a little difficult for the sister because when she was going distance, we walked over, which is about a half a mile from our apartment on Borgo D'Abruzzi, and she was in a wheelchair. But then when we got there was several curving stairs to go down, but she handled them very well. And we sat down, and we had a wonderful, she even drank a little red wine and said one of the funniest things I've ever heard from anybody, she was saying, because she lives a cloistered life, she said, you know, I didn't start drinking wine till I was 50. I thought that was pretty funny. At the time, she was 76. We had a delightful evening with her. She was spoke very well of my work and my time in Florence. And it was wonderful to be at that restaurant with her and her two traveling companions. And it was just a beautiful way to end their trip to my studio. Probably our most favorite outside cafe in 20 years in Florence is called the Caffè Rivoire, which is right in the center of Piazza della Signoria, where they have many of the original statues and sculptures from Florence, including the one you see in this painting of Neptune. And to the right of this is the famous Palazzo Vecchio. And right in front of us in the middle is a statue to Cosimo de' Medici. However, this one particular day stands out. It was actually an afternoon in December, and Susan and I were sitting there, and they normally have umbrellas up. But all of a sudden, this storm, this is not in the evening. Again, this is probably 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And the waiters ran out, and some of our most favorite characters are waiters that have been working at Rivoire over the last 20 years, including Salvatore, Roberto. Roberto, incidentally, has got a little part in the movie Hannibal with Anthony Hopkins. That part of it was filmed right in Piazza della Signoria. Giuseppe, Anselmo, many of our favorite people. But this particular day, they came out and they ran out. They brought all the umbrellas in because it started raining like hell. And we went inside, and we're looking out here from a window right on the sidewalk. And this is from, I didn't have my sketchbook, but we were doing we took many photos. Susan was with me, she had a camera, and when I got back to the studio, which at this time was on the Ponte Vecchio, I began to paint this painting. What I wanted to capture was how wet it was. So I spent a lot of time with the reflections on the in the street, in the square here, basically in the square. And you can see it really feels like water. In fact, it almost looks like it's a lake. And I did a lot of details. You can see in the buildings. This is a very, for me, a very technical composition. I don't normally do this kind of detail. But we've got the gas lamps and the cafes over to the left. And behind the statue is the place Michael Collins Pub, which is one of the new Irish pubs that have grown up in the city. But again, a lot of detail, a lot of what I really enjoy about the Tuscan colors and the buildings, you know, they're a little brighter in the painting than they are. And when I finally finished it, I just at the last minute, with about three brushstrokes, put this woman just sitting there, sort of waiting for someone. I think it really makes the painting. It gives it a sense of solitude that you feel when you are basically sitting in the rain. And I did a smaller version of this painting, and it is actually hanging in the Cafe Revoir, sort of directly behind from where we are sitting. And it's actually a frame painting, because everything in the inside of this cafe was built in the 1800s. All the paintings are framed because of the fact that people used to smoke. And normally you wouldn't frame an oil painting, but this one is under a glass frame. And if you're in Florence and you're traveling through the city, you might want to go in and check it out. The title of this painting is Frutta e Verdura. Means fruits and vegetables, and it's 24 by 32 inch oil on canvas. You know, we have all the great sites in Florence, the Palazzo Vecchio, the Duomo, Santa Croce, San Marco. There's so many beautiful places, the Bargello, but if this doesn't capture the spirit of the real Florence, in my opinion, it probably captured more than those the legendary cathedrals and piazzas of Florence. This is a simple fruit and vegetable stand in front of the store that our good friend Rosa owned and operated in Florence. We were able, around 2010, I believe, Susan and I were able to lease on a five-year basis this absolutely beautiful apartment on Via del Oriolio, which goes from the Duomo down to almost down to Santa Croce. But we started hanging out in a little different neighborhood than we had in the past, and we had a ritual. Every evening, when I finished painting and Susan finished writing, we would go out our apartment. And by the way, the apartment had the spectacular view from the roof. It was on the fourth floor. Most buildings can only go four stories. And we had a roof porch that I was able to paint on, and it had a 360-degree view of the city. Spectacular. So in the evening, not every evening, but several evenings, we would walk down to this area around one of our favorite new restaurants, Antica Noah, run by our good friend Massimo and his family. And around the corner was a little wine bar called Natalino. And we would go to Natalino's first, have a glass of wine, and they had little benches directly opposite this fruit stand. And this would be our view when it wasn't blocked by all the people walking down Borgo d'Abruzzi. A lot of times there were a combination of tourists and actually locals coming home or going to work. So Rosa would put out these vegetables. And to me, as I said before, it's just, this is the quintessential feeling of Florence. It's delicious fruits, vegetables. You can see them, the tomatoes, the broccolis, the oranges, everything, blueberries. And then she put them outside, and then of course she had many more of them inside. And she was just a wonderful person. And this became, again, one of our favorite stops before we would continue out to have dinner. And in fact, we got all our vegetables from Rosa, from this very place. And a couple of years ago, she actually moved around the corner. The place was taken over by, I think, a leather shop or something. But again, they were probably the most delicious fresh fruits and vegetables we ever had. And we're very thankful to have known her and had the opportunity to paint this. Thank you.